And then dedication accumulates the karma to attain the Buddha's body, the entire descriptions of the Buddha's body in general. So having done this practice of all the seven branches, then we make a mandala offering. The purpose of making this mandala offering, there are three great requests to make. The first request, requesting to the deities to stop all the mistaken or wrong the consciousness, the wrong mind in relation to how to follow a spiritual master, all incorrect that I have done in relation to following a correct master. And requesting to gain immediately the realization of generating a correct view by depending on all the virtue that I have done, such as having faith and respect to the spiritual master. And third one is requesting to eliminate all external and internal obstacles to practice the holy path. But if you do this practice in relation to the Tantra, then the first request is requesting to gain the subtle, the non-duality. So then remaining the two is same as before, but only in the first is different. In the first request, when it is not done in relation to the Tantra, then we do not mention to attain the state of unifications. Then comes the requesting prayer. While reciting the other prayer, then when you recite the Panden Tsawe Lama Rinpoche, at first time, a replica of the principal deity comes on the top of your head and facing same as you. So this the replica is like a request maker to the principal deity in the form of request maker on behalf of you.
Dudu was a jumper, and Raju Tenegazore. Sabata Jachi, Langer, and Toba Chavalatin, Gazan Tachiba Jan. Sabata Jachi, Langer, and Toba Tata, Julichi, or Randani Bashi Machet, Tayalamat, Yan and Randani Bashi Machet, Ralamati, Dudu was a jumper, Randani Bashi Machet, Dijan, and a consort. sabah da jachi ve lanchi rinpa dala da chewala den gejian tan chirpa jang sabah da jachi ve lanchi rinpa toba den dala da chesu sabah che henyebe kono ta tosan te yeji
then during the second recitation of the same prayer Panden Tsawe Lama we have to imagine that the replica of that deity which is on the top of your head is dissolved into you and also to think that immense light and nectar descending from the body and body filled with light and nectar, and then the light and nectar purifies all those obstacles to gain the realization of Lambrim are completely purified, and thereby you attain the realization of the Lambrim, a profound and extensive path. So then when you recite the parts of prayer where says the list of the names of all the deities of the extensive lineage, then at that time, same as before, rays of light and nectar descending from the body and the replica of those extensive lineage deity dissolve into your body, and they purify all the obstacles for gaining the realization of the extensive lineage, and then you get the realization of the extensive lineage by and also increases your lifespan, the merit. The same, you know, when you recite the names of the profound lineage, then rays of light and nectar enters into your body, and the replica of these deities dissolving into your body, thereby you receive the blessing and the realization of the profound the lineage.
Oh, that is the one 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 that is
Then comes the recitation of the prayer where the list of the name of the Kadam, the Lamrim's tradition, which is found below the deities of profound lineage. So again, the light and nectar descending from their body and the replica dissolve into your body, thereby purifying the negativities and obscurations to gain the realization of profound and extensive lineage, and thereby you attain the complete realization.
So the
first time is same as before, is the same everywhere. The first is simply the requesting to the deities. And at the first request, the deities arriving on the top of your crown level, and in the second recitation, the light and nectar descending from their body to receive the blessing. And then dissolve the deity into your body. The basic structures of the visualization is same as everywhere. So here we visualize the Kadampa lineage of scriptures. So you can visualize these three Kadampa traditions. Kadampa at the right and the left side of the Lama Lobsang Thuan Dorje Chang. There's all the three lineage at the right and all the three lineage at the left side. So the light and nectar descending from their body, the replica of this scriptural lineage come on the top of your head, and thereby you purify all the negativities, and then you get the realization of the profound and extensive lineage, lifespan and merit completely increase.
Oh, that then, Kadam Larimbe Lama. That the children and the short tally up, the children the short tally or. Oh, Kadam Larimbe Lama and Santa and so on this, the Yasuata. Lenny Becker, so on this, Lenny Becker. Does it major around any but yet? And Sabata Judge and Lodger and Tobacha Julicho and Gaja did it, John, Sesue J. Sabata Judge and Lodger Tobacha Julicho, Yabeta, Jimmy Nodgetan, Chibar, the Matata Chibar.
So then, same visualization should be done. For the Kadam Lamrimba tradition, which is found again at the right and left side of the principal of the deity.
Oh, that the name of Kadam Samay Lama. Mimetsu Tenshin is to do Yangon Lama Tonga Bachamune and Takadam Samay Lama. That the show yard, the show yard, Niga the man, the show down, the show Niga yard. Dana. Jaje Sabah Jaji Lanjir Toba Chabaji Julita, Jim Abache, and the name Badan, the Madonna Jibata.
So then a same visualization should be done to the Kadam, new Kadam tradition when you recite the prayer of Mingmi Seve. Then, first time you make a request, and in the second time, replica and rays of light and nectar descending from their body and the replica dissolving into your body. So these Kadam, new Kadam tradition deities found. Both one in the right and one in the left side.
Oh, then there were Kadam Betun and Choni into Kari and something. Somebody took it in Juba there, Kadam, just one of my yoder. Kadam, Lari Bada, Yumba, the Mamma, to my yoder. There's a Samotaj Juba there, Kondo my yoder. Kadam Lama to my yoder. Just the Nema in the castle. Tachi Juba Nibode, Chuji Red or.
So why the Kadamba traditions existing in both right and left side? Because the profound lineage goes also to the all the four Kadamba lineage and extensive lineage below of which there is all the four Kadamba tradition also goes to the four Kadampa lineage.
Ta nyang la ba tong ga ba chen ne ma chen ne ta chi ju ba ne bu chu chi de yin ba ma ze ga dang ju su ge ne ju ba ta sa ma chu chi de re de ro tin yin sa chuo ni ga no ga dang sa men la ma yong la de ju sen de yin ba ta
the fact of having in both sides that the new Kadampa tradition in right and left side is because Lama Tsongkhapa holds the joint traditions of two lineage, profound and extensive lineage.
Chodan de jaje chu ju ge damba dambe ju ba tene ka dang ne tsan ne yare samata ji ju ba ka dang ju so to so yo de re ha de ne de ni ge ju ba de ka dang sa me la ma so yo de re cha de ti ni de ni ga cho ni ga lo yong gu ya ju se de re
so this is the reason why in both sides there is the deities of four class of Kadampa tradition, which means these four Kadampa tradition possesses the both lineage, the extensive and profound lineage. This is the reason why they are visualized in both sides.
Other than Tonshin Togo, TJ, other, Lauritan, Shagun Rosen, Rosa Chairman, Yadeshin Jumander, and Shagun Chegur, that TJ, Lachogun Jelal, Yadeshin Jumander, and Lauri Shagun Chegur. Shagun Rosa Chairman, Yadeshin Jumander, go Yamane, and also Tonshin to Shadur.
So then here at this point, if you wanted to do the meditation on Lam Rim, the verification meditation, then here is the right moment to do that. But if you are not particularly doing the verification Lam Rim, then you have to recite a prayer called the Yundan Shi Gyurma at this point. So then after reciting that the prayer of the Yundan Shi Gyurma, then we do the visualization of the dissolution or the absorption of the field. So for that, from the heart of Lama Lobsang Thongwan Dojichang, there is at the heart there is the Vajradhara, and from the heart of Vajradhara, the light emanates in 10 directions, which covers entire the field of deity. And then from the edge, from the extreme, started to becoming contracts, smaller and smaller, like when you blow on the mirror. So that means the four directional protector dissolving into the Dagas and Dakinis. Likewise, it dissolves one into another.
Oh, then yeah, then you get bent out, you can't, then Sandy Jason chair, and the Suyaba. God, I'll tell you to do. The Suyadero, the Suliati. The Suyan, then yeah, Lama Lozanton, Dodgechang, Tuga, Dodgechang, Yati, remember, Chet.
So until receiving to the four topmost four petals, on the top of which there is the deities of the Goya Samaja, Heruka, Yamantaka, and the 16 drops of Kadampa tradition called 16 drops. So these are dissolving one into another, and then all these dissolve into Lama Lobsang Thongwan Dojichang, and then Lama Lobsang Thongwan Dojichang dissolve into Vajradhara. So this way we try to dissolve gradually one into another. That means the four Kadampa traditions deities dissolve one into another until receiving to the principal deity of that side, and then same for the left side, one into another until remaining up to the principle of deity.
Oh, that is then. That then is also there. What the Lama did, what the mean? That's how you just sing what you give a gentleman. Oh, never then. It's a sound like that. Go back to you. Oh, never check.
So that by visualizing these four deities on the top of four petals, that is Kuya Samacha, the Heruka Yamantaka, and Kadamba 16 drops, and in the center there is Lama Lobsang Thoban Dojichang. So at this point, we have to generate a very great joy in the mind, thinking that I am the one who has directly seen the five the Buddhas, the five deities.
What then? Jang Jayang Yebu Deda, Lama Lobsang Thoban Dojichang, Gopang Yuen Cha Timari, Gopang Yuen Cha
Here I make one mistake. Not deities of the four petals, huh? That is the principal deities of the Manjushri, Maitreya, Root Master, Vajradhara, and Lama Lobsang Thoban Dojichang.
So the
except root master remaining the three deities are melt into light and dissolve into the principal the deity, but the root lama does not melt in the light, but he dissolves into the heart of the principal deity straight away without melting into light, like a small grain, you know, or enters into heart.
Wow, that work passing the heart, that sense you are, passing the heart, sense that then, Lama Lobsang Thoban Dojichang, then, by my day, then, that by day, no, yeah, by my day, then, by my day, that, you day, then, that day, you are, that's all you have.
And then the wish-granting tree and the huge throne dissolve into the cushion of the Lama Lobsang Thoban Dojichang, such as lotus, the moon, and sun cushion.
Oh, so Lama Lobsang Thoban Dojichang, then, bedan to say, then, rang jewel, take it to Lama Yoba, the bedan of Mati.
Then the three, the cushions, the lotus, sun, and moon dissolve into the cushion of one's root master, which is seen at the top of your crown, and then Lama Lobsang Thoban Dojichang dissolve into your root master, which is you visualize at the top of your crown. Then one's root master should be seen here in the form of Buddha Shakyamuni, and thinking that this is the essence of the integration of the Three Jewels refuge. And then at this point, by visualizing one's root guru in the form of Buddha Shakyamuni, we make seven branches offering with the mandala offering, a short one.
That is a puzzle sunday, so I don't worry. Puzzle sunday, so I don't put a job on logic, then Uzu Javan, that's what I got.
So then comes the request, a very strong request is made at this point. Extremely strong, it is called the Puzzuk request, which means insistence, strongly insisting.
When the Puba Javan, the Puba Javan, the Ran on Uzu Janama.
Like when you put a purpa when you were on the ground, you hit on the top of again and again until it really goes deep and remains strong, the purpa on the ground. In the same way, the request is so insistently, strongly made to that the Buddha Shakyamuni. So this the strong insisting request prayer is found in the Georgia, in the Georgia text. So until you recite after the Tuan Doji Chan La Soa Dev, so this request, insisting strong request is made to to that Buddha Shakyamuni, which is at the top of your head. So, depending on what occasion you are doing this practice, if you are principally meditating on love and compassion, something relation to the practice of love and compassion, then instead of saying, I make request to the Lama Lobsang Thowang Dojichang, who is the possessor and nature of the four kayas, you can say, I make request to the compassionate, the deity Adi Chenrisik, who possesses the four types of Buddha's body. But when you are doing a ritual practice which relates to the practice of emptiness, then you can say, I make a request to the Lama Manjushri, who is the nature of the four the kayas. So up to here, all what we have learned is all about the practice of preliminary, the preparation practice, and then actual practice of Lamim starts from how to follow a correct, how to follow correctly a spiritual master. Now the request was that we make to the Lama who is seen at your crown level, saying that I myself and including all the sentient beings who were suffering from immeasurable lifetime in these great oceans of cyclic existence. It's because of not following correctly in terms of attitude and in terms of behavior or action a spiritual master. Therefore, I make request to you now that may I and including all sentient beings, please grant your benediction to be able to follow a spiritual master correctly in terms of attitude and behavior. And then, because of our request, the five-colored light and nectar descending from that the Lama the Shakyamuni, and the light covers the light and nectar covers entire the sentient being that you have visualized nearby you, and thereby eradicate all those the obstacles, not able to follow our spiritual master correctly, and now you received a full blessing. Then to think that your body and the body of all sentient being completely purified, so clean, like become like a crystal glass, and then it increases all your lifespan, merits and positive energies and qualities. And think that a very special realization is being generated in the mind of all sentient being and yours, a realization that are able to follow correctly the spiritual master. And then to contemplate and meditate on the benefits of following a correct master. So there are eight principal benefits of following a master correctly. The first benefit of following our spiritual master correctly is that brings closer to attain enlightenment. There's two interpretations. How it brings closer is because of Lama gives you special spiritual instruction. Or second one is because of receiving the teaching from your Lama. So then to think that if one is able to attain the state of enlightenment within the shortest lifetime of degeneration, if you are able to do this, is because of the Lama's kindness of giving you the teaching, and it's because of following a spiritual master correctly. So thereby, if you get closer and become a shorter distance between you and the state of enlightenment.
And
also to think that if tantric path becomes extremely profound and extremely quick to attain enlightenment, it's only because of your practice of Guru Yoga. That means again, it depends on spiritual master.
As
it is said in the text called Duzi Ningbo, the essence of nectar, that if one is able to attain the state of unification in within the shortest lifetime of degeneration, it's again because of following correctly a spiritual their master.
Then
Then to think or to contemplate the story of the Bodhisattva called one who is crying all the time. So at the beginning of the path, he was abiding in the great path of accumulation. And then later on, when he was able to meet or to find his master, the Chöpa, he was already at the eighth level of a Bodhisattva Bhumi. So he reached in such a level of state because of he followed the spiritual master correctly in terms of motivation and in terms of the behavior. So because of the power of following the spiritual master, it is said that he is able to complete the merit of two great countless eons. And to think that if I put into practice even a one single advice that you receive, it brings the closer to the state of enlightenment. The each time when you try to put into practice the each advice given by the Lama, then each time you get closer.
And then to think that
when there is a disciple who is very courageous and who really followed our spiritual master correctly in terms of motivation and in terms of behavior, when that disciple is met with a qualified spiritual master who is able to show a complete path to the enlightenment. So when these two gets together, then the state of Buddhahood is same as that you can make with your own hand. The state of Buddhahood becomes like hand of making by your own hand. And also the famous Indian master Pathapa Sanke, he said that if Lama takes you, if Lama wants, then he will take you wherever you desire to attain the levels. Therefore, it is important to have pure devotion and respect and faith in Lama. So then Nagarjuna said that even if you think that you may not fall from the high the mountain, but when even if you think, but when it happens, you will fall, and there's no way to escape. So in the same way, if the Lama wants, even if you think that you will not able to liberate, but something that you think impossible, but it will be possible and able to liberate. Even if you think that you don't want to attain, you will attain.
So
So then we shall try to meditate a little bit on this part of teaching, particularly how to follow a spiritual master and a little bit of contemplation, and then we shall stop here.
Ayatan nazo chenye sabe gewa le tan don do wa kwa ma kwa che bara je zan lo zan cha ba ten be nye bo re te je yo ka re da yo kwe chi ba ten don de wa ma le che re je wa tin tin ja so cha be se te ba ten yo ro je Dagger
The great Indian master called Shantideva, he said that at the moment we have obtained the human, the form of rebirth, the body, which has similar function of the boat, the bateau, which can cross the great the ocean.
No, she tends to master the table, set up them to paint it, that turns to draw this girl.
So, having obtained such a precious human rebirth, which has a capacity like the boat can cross the great ocean, the same way the depending on the human rebirth, one can cross from the oceans of cycle existence.
Oh, tadi tene ben nashi tene jundi madde madruba che madruba yena mi chundi ta dunge chu ta dunge di jato chemel jeve chuta bi mi lede chini nye kabo shirare zwa yema ta.
So if today we do not take any essence out of that, means if we do not try to make it meaningful, then in the future it is extremely difficult to get the same opportunity. Therefore, today we should not remain or stay like as you were sleeping, doing nothing, but to wake up and to make necessary effort. So it doesn't matter whether one thinks that there is a lot of human being or not, but one should think for oneself, about oneself, which means to get the same opportunity to be born as a human being again is extremely the rare.